Hi everyone, Alfred here from Alfred.tv. Yeah, can't keep a straight face. So, where are we? What are we doing right now? Yeah, it's another unboxing, but let's give a status update. The Drobo 8D was a complete tech fail. Either just, you know, poor quality control, defective unit, or just crappy software, whatever. This thing's going back and I'm replacing it with the device in that box, which I'm gonna go open now. Bottom line is that Drobo failed in getting me a replacement unit on Saturday like I wanted. So I called the fine folks up at Otherworld Scumputing. I paid 80 bucks for FedEx Priority 1 Saturday delivery and I got that replacement item. So let's unbox it. Okay, the official shiv was deployed to unveil the OWC ThunderBay 6. A professional grade 6-bay RAID array, and this is a Thunderbolt 3 device, so it will be good for, you know, the future when I get the new Mac Pro 7.1. Yeah, sure, let's unbox this thing. Well, there is the device. It's a fairly heavy hunk of metal, and oh wow, it comes with like a free toy, this bag. It says this bag is not a toy. Damn. Okay, contents of the box, panel cord, Los Llaves, because I'm in South Florida, keys, a shit ton of screws, Thunderbolt 3 cable, and some instructions for installing the drives and installing the SoftRAID software. Nice and simple. There we go. Okay, so you put in the key, and the door comes off. And here we have the six bays. So the bottom line, we're going to unscrew the bay and put the drive into the card cage and screw them back in. Nice. Okay, so Return of the Screw is a good book. And it exposes the tray for the drive. So a little bit of a screw job here and should be no big deal. You know, looking at the instructions, it says that the drives must be formatted before putting them in the box. So I'm going to take care of that first. And also on a side note, the box is controlled by a piece of software called SoftRAID, and SoftRAID version 5. Whatever is not yet compatible with APFS. So I'm going to format these six drives as normal Macintosh, you know, HFS. All right, so let's do the formatting first. You see, I got a little ahead of myself. I was already ready to do the screw job on this thing. I'll tell you, these things are very handy. The Voyager Q drive dock. So I'm just going to insert each of the six drives in there and format them for HFS Plus. Nice. Oh no, we're not using ScreenFlow, so I'll just label them drive underscore A, B, C, D, etc. Format Mac OS extended journaled scheme guide partition map. Nice. Okay, and that is the proper orientation for the drive. I'm going to put in the screws, and they actually give another set of screws. You can put in 2.5-inch SSUDs, SSDs in here as well. So that's kind of nice. The bracket accommodates the 3.5-inch drive as well as the 2.5-inch drives. Okay, and let's see how we do with the docking of the drive. Okay, that's it. It's in. And then we just tighten up this at the top. And I'm going to repeat with the other drives. Now, obviously, OWC sells this 6-bay device with the drives preloaded and formatted and ready to rock and roll. I had an inventory of drives from the failed Drobo 8D, so this is the route that I chose that made most sense because I had the drives in inventory. Let me continue and we'll get this thing up. So you'll see on the back of the device there are two Thunderbolt 3 ports, you know, the format. Of course, the connector is a USB-C, and there's also a port in there for video out or whatever. And the software that's going to control the drives is called SoftRAID. The serial number of the software is under the bottom of the box. So I already took a picture of it with the phone. And man, this is, like I said, nice heavy hunk of metal. Okay, so let's power up the box. Contact. Okay. And now I'm going to power up the trash can. Okay, and once I turned on the Mac Pro, the trash can, then this thing came to life. So it was definitely waiting for a signal over that, you know, USB-C Thunderbolt 3 converted to Thunderbolt 2, whatever. port. And by the way, you know, what's recommended is Apple's branded Thunderbolt 3 to Thunderbolt 2 cable, because I guess some of the cables are unidirectional. The Apple cable is bidirectional. It's bi. And on boot, the six individual drives are indeed showing up, which means I could have inserted them without the pre-format. It would have been just done on this system, not a big deal. But I am actually going to format them again just for the hell of it, and then I'm going to install SoftRAID to bind them together as one logical drive. So just to be clear, this is not a hardware-based RAID array. I mean, there's some firmware in there for sure, but the grouping of the drives is done through SoftRAID. SoftRAID. It's late, all right? Okay, so the software SoftRAID Lite is in. I did actually have trouble with the serial number. It didn't recognize it. It probably has to be entered and propagated into the database at OWC and SoftRAID's end, since this thing was like a rush job. But it is running in trial mode, and I'll straighten that out Monday morning with tech support. Not a big deal. So it's showing the 6 8 terabyte drives, and I'm going to select and bind these together as a RAID 1 mirrored set for maximum protection. Now, the software does prompt on how you're going to be using the storage device. It gives the options: workstation, general use, server, digital video, digital audio, digital photography. I am going to select digital video, though for all intents and purposes, if I'm editing a new project, it's going to be on the internal SSD. But if I go back to an older project, I guess this will fine-tune maybe some blocking parameters and tweak how the software, you know, allocate space on the drive. And so we're going to go with digital video. Well, some of this doesn't make sense. I mean, RAID 1 mirrored doesn't make sense. If it's mirrored with six drives, my yield is going to be still one very safe 8 terabyte volume where five drives can fail. I think what I really want is to upgrade to the full SoftRAID program, not SoftRAID Lite, and do a RAID 5 setup, which would yield the 40 terabyte volume, so with redundancy and whatnot. My other thought is that the serial number is actually for the full SoftRAID app and not SoftRAID Lite, again, on a 6 bay device. So at this point, I'm going to pause. I'm not going to format this thing for RAID 1 with 6 drives. It doesn't make any sense to get an 8 terabyte yield. I normally just take 2 8 terabyte drives, pair them together as RAID 1 mirrored. But so we're going to pause now. The hardware is set up. Everything seems to be working fine. I'll make a call to tech support tomorrow and make a few tweaks, and then rock and roll. All right, we'll be back. Okay, so I had a chat with Otherworld Computing technical support. Let me clarify a few things and share with you what I've learned. There's four versions of SoftRAID. There's SoftRAID, SoftRAID Lite, I have trouble saying it. Then there's SoftRAID XT and SoftRAID XT Lite. So I had installed SoftRAID Lite. That's why the serial number got bounced out. But what I really want, though, is first of all, the XT version, the XT flavors of SoftRAID are made specifically for the OWC ThunderBay, these enclosures. All right, they're made specifically for that. I'm actually running SoftRAID on the Mac Pro 5.1. I use it to manage the internal mirrored RAID array. I have 2 4 terabyte drives mirrored and handled under SoftRAID and an active SoftRAID license. So actually, the enclosure, there's 2 flavors of the no drive enclosure from Otherworld Computing. There's one with SoftRAID XT Lite, and then there's another bundle of the enclosure with no drives with just the full version of SoftRAID XT. And the variance between the two flavors is that the Lite version does RAID 0, which is taking just a bunch of drives and binding them together to one large volume. Of course, they call it scary RAID because there's no redundancy. And it also does RAID 1, which is mirrored. Now, in my situation, I have 6 8 terabyte drives. If I put it under a mirrored operation. Well, shit, I have 5 drives of redundancy, but only a net yield of storage of 1 8-terabyte drive. That's not what I want. I want RAID 5, which offers some safety and redundancy, and I can have one drive fail. So I'm going to back out. Well, I already backed out SoftRAID Lite, and I'm going to install SoftRAID XT. Other World Computing was real good. They're going to send me a license code, and I'm just paying the difference as if I had bought the enclosure with that flavor of SoftRAID. I said, really, people buy this enclosure and do RAID 0? And he says, yeah, those are people who just want a huge amount of storage and they want the speed. I mean, obviously, they back it up with something else, but I don't want that. I want a RAID 5 enclosure. So I'm going to install SoftRAID XT. I'll just put it into 30-day trial mode. When the license comes in, I'll just apply it later. Not a big deal. And we'll get this thing up and running. Nice. Oh, one other thing I clarified with tech support. If you remove the back panel, there's an area to put an M.2 solid-state drive. And at first, I thought maybe this was for speed enhancements and for caching. No, that's not what it's for. It's if you just want another solid-state drive on your desktop, they provision it with a slot. I don't need that, so I didn't get it. I mean, if it was something to enhance throughput and it was used as a cache by the software, then it would have been worth it. But clarification, it's not used for caching purposes. It just puts another solid-state drive on your Mac desktop. But it's a nice feature, though, for futures if you need it. Okay, so now I'm using the QuickTime screen recorder. Wow, fancy schmancy. And software XT. I'm running the easy setup, driver's installed, it recognizes these drives in the OWC box, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, all good, continue, and we want one RAID volume, and we're going to call it Synapse, and I'm going to set it for digital video, and yes, we want RAID 5, and it's going to have a yield of 40 terabytes. Continue. Blah, blah, blah. Enable volume saver for new RAID on it. Yes. Ding, ding, ding. Real easy. Click, click, click. Click, clack, click, clack. Yeah. Set up. Okay. Doing its thing. Unmounting those individual volumes, which have all been formatted beforehand. And like I said, if you put the raw drives in the enclosure, I mean, the Mac would have kicked in disk utility where you can format them individually. I had formatted them in an external drive dock on my other Mac Pro. And I hope I don't spoil my viewing audience. You're typically used to me pointing the camera at the screen. I guess I'll have to put some shake in post-production. Maybe not. Maybe I'll just speed this whole thing up. All right, 40% done. All right, doing its thing. Again, very easy. Click, click. Please be patient. All right, it's actually doing the initialization as well. It's reformatting them again. That's fine. Now listen, if I really wanted to be anal, if I really want to be like meticulous, I could have taken each of those drives and did like a low-level format just to shake out any potential bad blocks, but I think we'll be fine. And like I said, it's a RAID 5 array. Array. 64%. Trying to come up with commentary, it's difficult. Not really. Of course, I'm doing this while there's a freaking thunderstorm going on outside, but I am plugged into a battery backup for both the trash can and the OWC ThunderBay, and it's a fairly large battery backup, so it should hold for more than just a blip. You know, that common problem, though. A lot of people get the battery backups and they're not careful where they plug the devices in. You know, one side of the backup is indicated for you know, just surge only. I can't tell you how many times over my course of working in an office environment where people plugged them into the wrong side. They just did surge only. Didn't have it in the battery backup side. It's a good whoops. Okay, we're at 83%. It's doing its thing. I can hear the thunder. I can hear the thunder growling outside. Welcome to South Florida. I did get a nice alert on my Apple Watch about some storm that's going to be quite nasty. Oh yeah, it's really amazing how they have that weather data, radar data pumped in. It's good to know if you're going to go to the beach or not. All right, the drive lights on the box are kind of like blinking. It's doing its thing. Setup complete. Your surfer volume is now ready to use. Would you like to open your new RAID volume in the Finder? Open the volume. Hooray. Okay. And this is done. And I'm going to give a serial number shortly. And let's stop the screen record. How do you do that? I don't know, you press buttons. But it's all done, and the yield is a 40 terabyte volume, which I titled Synapse, and good to go. Now I'm gonna start loading up data, and we'll see how it does. Yeah, so back to the old-fashioned way. This is the Soft RAID XT. This is the main control panel, and it's showing, you know, the six drives that are bound together into this one drive called Synapse at 40 terabytes. Nice. Select target drive. No, I want to select a Walmart drive. Really bad joke. What the hell else? All right, so we're doing a test on Synapse and start. There we go. Okay, we're getting some decent write speeds. And remember, this is a Thunderbolt 3 drive, but I've, you know, basically crippled it by running it ThunderBay 2 because that's what the trash can offers. So here are read write speeds, blah blah blah, and we'll let it run for another minute or two so you can see what's going on. And for all intents and purposes, from what I remember, it's actually a hell of a lot better than the Drobo, without any doubt. So we'll let this sit and let it complete. Actually, I had done the speed test prior, and I didn't select the ThunderBay. I kept it pointing at the internal, you know, solid state drive in the trash can. I'm like, holy shit, man, this blows away everything. Matter of fact, as a goof, I guess I should post that clip right after to see my reaction, how amazed I was. But it was a total, it was erroneous data. So I guess this thing is like almost done. My ADD is kicking in, but you get the idea. The ThunderBay 6 runs just quite lovely using Soft RAID XT. Nice. How do I stop this shit again? Control, Command, Escape. Let's see if that works. So I'm running Blackmagic speed tests. Overall, nothing too impressive, but that was never the point. Remember that the Drobo 8D is inherently crippled. I don't have all the bays optimized. I'm running mechanical drives, and I'm throttling down from Thunderbolt 3 to 2 on an old trash can. It was more about the flexibility and the safety of the overall storage unit. That was the main driver for getting the 8D. Okay, and speaking of that Drobo device again, let's talk about what its advantages were. Assuming I had a proper working, good quality control unit, which I don't. Matter of fact, UPS just picked up the 8D. It's like sayonara now, okay? But the advantage of the Drobo is that you can mix and match drive sizes. You can tell it that you want dual disk redundancy. The software is very sophisticated. But to me, this thing is a much more logical solution. So I just initiated a transfer of my Final Cut Pro, Final Slut Pro libraries from the Mac Pro 5.1 to the trash can. And this is what the Dance of the Lights looks like, all right? And we're moving close to 480 gigs. The timestamp is 2:18. I'll try to get an idea of how long it takes, but rock and roll. But that's it. if I don't film any subsequent clips of me yelling, screaming, and cursing, that means everything is good. All right? So let's hope for the best. And I'm going to say more to come.
Mordecai!
More to come. Stay tuned. Holy crap. Just for shits and giggles, I ran that black magic speed test. I mean, this is getting, you know, write operations at 1192, read operations 13 and change. I mean, that Drobo 8D, the numbers are like, you know, 250, 300 on both sides or lower. So this thing, like, just like blows away the 8D with regard to read-write speeds. No comparison. Oh, and look at this fine Alfred.TV cinematography. It looks so pretty.
Welcome to Alfred.TV.